Good morning. Today we are going to start with a new chapter of class 10 physics, that is sources of energy. Sources of energy. First of all, you people have learned in your class 9 what is energy. Fine. Energy, that is the capacity to do work or the ability of a body to do work. You people know that the SI unit of energy is joule. Unit of energy is joule. Any type of energy, the SI unit is always be joule. Now, we have to start with the source of energy. What is the source of energy? Always we get energy from any type of the object. Fine. Here we have to study what are the different objects from which where we get the energy. So, what is the source of energy? Any object which gives us sufficient amount of energy for the long duration of the time. If suppose I have one object and I burn and I'll get energy for 1 minute, that object will get burned for 1 minute. And you have the same amount of any other object which burn for 5 minutes. So 5 minutes that and that's providing more energy. So that object is a better source of energy. Sources of energy, we have the two types. One is a non-renewable, second is a renewable. As name suggests, non-renewable, it means which cannot be renewed, which cannot be get again. Second is renewable, once we use again further we can use and we can get easily. Other name of the non-renewable source of energy is the conventional source of energy, and the other name of renewable source of energy is the non-conventional source of energy. Now, non-renewable source of energy. Those sources which are abundant in nature but once finished cannot be formed again or cannot be replaced again. For example, coal, petroleum and gases. Coal, petroleum and gases, they are formed deep under the earth under high pressure and high temperature and also takes millions of the year. Then we get those sources of the energy, that is coal, petroleum and the gases. They are abundant in nature, but once it will be finished, once we get over all these types of fuels, we cannot get again. So they are known, also known as the exhaustible, means finished sources of the energy. One more fuel, that is a nuclear. Nuclear fuel. Under this fuel, we have a one element, that is uranium. Uranium is a one of the element which we used in nuclear reactor as a fuel. It provides a very large amount of energy, but once it will be finished in our nature, we will not get again. Presence of uranium is very less in whole world, and in India it's as compared to whole world it's only 1 or 2%. The second type of energy is renewable source of energy. As I told you, name suggests renewable, which can be get again, renewed. So those sources of energy which are being produced continuously in our nature, they are known as a renewable source of energy. Few examples are, first is hydro energy. Hydro means water. We get the energy from water. For example, in water dam. Next, we have a wind energy. The energy which we get by moving, fast moving air. Third is solar energy. Solar means sun energy. Fourth, tidal energy. Tidal energy means the tides, jo lehre uthti hain samudra mein, that is a tidal energy, that is tides in the sea. Next is the geothermal. Geo means earth, thermal means heat. So that is the deep inside the earth. We have a three layers of the earth, that is crust, mantle, core. So mantle, in the mantle part, middle, the temperature is more. So from there. Next is the biomass energy. The biomass energy, the word bio means living. So this biomass energy we get from the waste of the living organism, animals, plants and others. One thing more, sun is the ultimate source of energy. Sun is the ultimate source of energy. Till the time sun is present, this type of energy will get.